Well, we actually managed to stop raising our voice with my wife. It was not easy, maybe because we were used to it from our childhood. But what about our parents? My parents, they keep raising and they refuse to stop because they don't believe that.
Yeah, I got it. So that's gonna keep happening. And yeah, you can give them something to read if they're interested. But they're probably not. I know. I know all your parents. It's all the same. What you want to do is what I said earlier. Children need to be exposed to a lot of kinds of people. This way, you know, if they're only exposed to you and the grandparents, then the influence is much too strong because there is not much else. But if they have lots of people, then the impact of the grandparents is not so great. It's one out of many. And when they go, the grandparents, see if you can put it in perspective for them. So you say, oh, we're going to grandma. Oh, she's gonna go, good boy, good girl. She's gonna do her thing, you know? So you empower them that it doesn't mean anything, you know, by making a little fun of it. And then if she actually does it, then on the way back home, you can remind us like, yeah, she did it exactly like what we said. Remember, you did the, you know, you build this or you helped her. She's so cute. We love her very much. So it's not a put down. So let other people be who they are and help your children have perspective on it when they're young. And later on, they'll have perspective simply by seeing lots of different people. So some people praise, some people... At the end, you have the biggest impact, which is a problem too. Which is why I say, have more people, so they don't take you too seriously. That was my greatest mistake, probably, with my children. I had much too much of an impact on them. And they had to work harder as adults to learn to accept more points of view and more ways to be than just this one powerful dominating